Have you heard that lightning never strikes the same place twice? Were you told to stand far away from a microwave because its radiation is dangerous? Were you taught that the North Star is the brightest star in the sky? You may be surprised to learn that none of the statements are true. Lightning can strike one place multiple times. Just think about the Empire State Building. Microwaves are completely safe as long as you don't stick your nose against the door for an extended period of time. And the sun is actually the brightest star in the sky, or Sirius if you're looking at the night sky. Scientific misconceptions are commonly held beliefs about science that have no basis in actual scientific fact. These facts are believable due to insufficient prior knowledge and are perpetrated because of the lack of effort in finding empirical evidence. Whenever we learn something new, we use our prior knowledge to help make sense of the new information. However, when our prior knowledge is inaccurate, we are more likely to misinterpret or misunderstand new information. This is the basis of how a misconception is formed. Misconceptions may also originate from preconceived notions based on religious and cultural influences or because of faulty teaching styles. One psychology professor from the University of Southern California, Norbert Schwartz, studied why humans are susceptible to misinformation. His results show that people are more likely to accept misinformation as fact if it's easier to hear or read, if it's compatible with pre-existing known information, and whether others believe it. Another psychology professor from the University of Bristol in the United Kingdom stated that the fundamental problem with misinformation is that once people have heard it, they tend to believe and act on it even after it's been corrected. Acting on this misinformation can mean adjusting thoughts and lifestyles to fit this new idea and even sharing the information with others, thus leading to the spread of the misconception. In today's society, one of the fastest and most powerful avenues for spreading information, whether that be true or false, is social media. Misinformation on social media spreads quickly in comparison to traditional media because of the lack of regulation and examination required before posting. As such, platforms such as Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and TikTok can spread misinformation, fake news, and propaganda like wildfire. One example of when a news article exaggerated the findings of a research study was an article published by the Daily Mail in 2015. The news article read, "Are smartphones making us stupid? Googling information is making us mentally lazy," study claims. Pretty bold statement, huh? And did the research actually conclude this? Well, not quite. And this is how these bold claims can lead to bold assumptions in the public. Let's take a closer look at this example by highlighting the key findings of the paper and tracing how they were exaggerated in the media and how this can lead to misconceptions. The first thing that catches your eye of anything is the title. Authors want you to read their specific article, and this can sometimes lead to the creation of bold and exaggerated titles in order to get views. This is the concept of clickbait. As you can see with this example, there's a clear disconnect between the original research article, its press release, and two news articles which reference the study, one by the Daily Mail and one by CBC News. While the research article is titled "The Brain in Your Pocket: Evidence That Smartphones Are Used to Supplant Thinking," the press release and news articles made the conclusion sound much more definitive by saying that smartphone use is linked to lazy thinking. News articles tend to be a very concise summary of research findings. Ideally, they should provide a comprehensive summary of all the research findings, but in reality, they tend to focus on dramatic results while frequently omitting the null findings. These are findings in which no association was found, and although not as exciting, they are still informative and provide important context and meaning to the research. While the news article presented the finding that those who used their smartphone more frequently tended to have a lower cognitive ability and a more intuitive cognitive style, it regretted to inform the reader of many of the null findings. These include that there was no such association with the amount of time using the smartphone for social media and entertainment purposes, and a lack of a significant difference on the various cognitive measures between smartphone owners and non-owners. When news articles focus on dramatic findings, they can falsely imply that there is a definitive causal relationship between two variables. This highlights an important distinction made in the scientific field regarding correlation and causation. While it is much easier to think of things in terms of a cause and effect relationship, sometimes the science is not that conclusive, particularly when it is based on preliminary data. Therefore, especially in this case, correlation does not equal causation. As one of the authors of the research article states, our research provides support for an association between heavy smartphone use and lowered intelligence. Whether smartphones actually decrease intelligence is still an open question that requires future research. Context such as this was lacking, particularly in the Daily Mail article, which instead advertised a clear link between less time on the phone and stronger cognitive skills, and was only mentioned at the very end of the CBC article. Now that you've seen how misconceptions are spread, let's talk about some tips and tricks to combat them. One way to avoid believing misconceptions is to be curious. Ask yourself questions when you are presented with a fact online. Is this the best source to get accurate scientific information? Do the content creators actually know what they are talking about? Have they done their research? Can the information be backed up by actual experimental evidence? Or is this just a bunch of hearsay? We know it can be difficult to not believe them right away, but we encourage you to think twice about the scientific facts presented in news articles and via social media. Always take it with a grain of salt. Next, introducing science to kids at an early age can develop positive attitudes towards science and credible research, which will help them in the long run. If introduced early on in their lives, it can also lead to better understanding of the concepts. Hence, one way to avoid the spread of scientific misconceptions is by exposing kids to scientific concepts at an early age. Lastly, scientists play an important role in preventing science miscommunication. Scientists can write summaries about their research findings in layman words to help the general public understand their study better. This will be a pivotal step in bridging the gap between science and the public. If you want additional resources for how to further combat science misconceptions, be sure to check out the links in the description bar below.